Start spreading the news. I'm leaving today. I want to be a part of it. New York, New York.
It's been waiting for you. Welcome to New York. Welcome to New York.
After what feels like 6 hours of traveling, I'm finally here in New York with my mother, and we are so happy to be here. Before we continue the vlog, I need to rant about the travel. So we go through customs and then we travel for like an hour to New York. But you see, our airport was kind of far away from our hotel. So we literally had to travel like for 3 hours from Newark to Times Square. So the only con was a whole traveling experience. People were texting and driving, singing in their car, like blasting their music, or cursing at us because, you know, New York drivers are like cutting each other every single second. The only pro, or so far the pro is, of our hotel and how great it is that it's in the middle of Times Square, so literally you can just walk out, cross the street, or turn right or turn left, and you'll be in Times Square in the middle of everything. You can find anything you want. So far, what we've been lucky and blessed with is some food. We've been starving. We haven't eaten since like 6 a.m. in the morning. Guess what we had to eat? Olive Garden. And what do we get from Olive Garden? The breadsticks. Of course, the breadsticks. If you're never going to Olive Garden, I'm gonna tell you, you have to go to Olive Garden. Wherever you go, make sure there's an Olive Garden nearby because this is amazing. Basically, what this is just bread covered in garlic, but the secret is it's topped with a little bit of salt. So when you first bite into it, you taste the salt and then like kickstarts your taste buds to taste whatever, and then it goes into the garlic and then smoothly goes into the bread. And it's just a beautiful transition. Really good. Right, Mom? Is the bread good? She's nodding yes. Can't see her, but she's nodding yes. Which means Maria Roy approved, Mama Roy approved. It's approved. I just wanted to interrupt the vlog for a little bit and talk about my experience of how I've traveled here for day one. And now we're gonna go to Wall Street. So continue watching the vlog and enjoy the trip with me. Been like 4 or 5 hours since I last updated you, and we just came back from Wall Street. People always say that when you get out of the subway station or when you enter, you're gonna smell poop. I thought, oh, that's false. So we came here to Times Square and nothing smelled really bad until we got to Wall Street. Do you see these things right here? Yeah, this, as you walk by them, the smell it gives off, it's like you ate Mexican food, came home, took a dump, did not flush the toilet for like 3 days. Okay, that's an exaggeration, but like you get what I mean, right? It literally smells like poop, and it's just ugh, it's awful. Now we're back here. I got myself some Mountain Dew because I need some energy for later. If you know me very well, then you would know that I'm a huge fan of Pentatonix. Pentatonix is this a cappella group consisting of 5 people that can sing a cappella, basically. And I've been listening to them since 2014, and I finally got myself some tickets to watch them sing live. So my mom and I are going to Beacon Theater at 7, and they're gonna be in front of me. That's here.
Pentatonix.
Mm-hmm.
So today is December 21st, which means it's the second day of New York, and I did not vlog anything today because since it's the second day of New York, I decided to actually put my feet inside of New York and live the life of a New York tourist. Today what we did was go to Madame Tussauds Museum. If you don't know what that museum is, basically it's a museum full of wax figures of different celebrities that you can see in person, and you can actually see how short or tall they are, and it's like really unbelievable. So I took a bunch of pictures with all of them. On our way to our actual street, we went from the 42nd to the 50th. Basically, we got to see the Rockefeller Center, and it was the most beautiful thing ever, and we could see the Rockefeller tree, which was where Home Alone 2 was. If you know that movie, preach girl, preach. It's a beautiful movie. That's all we did so far, and tomorrow's vlog will probably be more interesting than this because we are actually going to museums first of all, and we're going to a Brooklyn Bridge. So yeah, just wait for next vlog and I'll see you guys then. And we're back from a long day of walking, and this girl is finally hungry, and on our way back to our hotel we stopped by Chick-fil-A. If you don't know what Chick-fil-A is, it's an American McDonald's type of thing with a bunch of things that are related to chicken. We're gonna try some Chick-fil-A. I got myself some basic chicken nuggets. That's all I'm hungry for. What matters the most is that we're gonna try it with the Chick-fil-A sauce, which people always swear by and say that it's really good. To dip or not to dip? That is the question. The chicken itself is really soft and crunchy at the same time. The sauce is really weird. Mustard mixed with honey and barbecue. Not bad. It's just out of the ordinary and out of the comfort zone because I've never had this before. Usually if I eat chicken nuggets at McDonald's, I always eat the sweet and sour sauce. This is like different. So I need to rant for a second. So this morning I had some McDonald's and I was asked what kind of drink I want. I was like, ooh, I want some tea. Me, in my head, I'm thinking Nesty. If you know what Nesty tastes like, just figure the taste in your mouth and make it like appear in your mouth. I don't know what I'm talking about. But anyways, if you know what Nesty is, you know the taste of it. So that's what I want. So she was like, okay, do you want sweetened tea or do you want unsweetened? I'm like, okay, if the Nesty is not sweet, what's the point of it? So I'm like, oh, obviously sweetened tea. Or sweet tea, whatever it's called. What I get is not Nesty. I get some black tea that's cold. So imagine making yourself a black tea, put it in outside in the cold, and then adding like 6 teaspoons of sugar in there. Like, it's so sweet and so gross. We're on our way to the airport in a limousine. It was like right in front of the
white limousine.
Yeah, but we were right in front of the hotel on our way, or trying to find a taxi, but no, this limousine was just like, okay, we'll drive you there. I mean, I'm not complaining. But
walking out of town, looking for a better place. Something's on my mind. Always in my space, but I know someday I'll make it.
Hey guys, as you can see, I'm finally home. Put on a face mask to relax a little bit. Overall, New York was really fun. The fun part was obviously to see all the landmarks and to see the view. Got to experience New York in its prime time in Times Square and all of the above. But overall, it was way too busy for me, way too overcrowded. I'm a little girl and I get claustrophobic, and if it's really busy, then I don't like it. I like being like, you know, in my own individual space. going where I wanted to go. For next time, if I will visit New York another day, I will definitely visit a place that is a lot quieter. Definitely go to Central Park and just walk around because I haven't gotten a chance to go there. But that's what I'll do next time. Next time I also go with myself and only myself because my mom was a little bit stressful. I hope you guys enjoyed all these vlogs of my adventure, and I'm really happy to be home. See you in the next videos.